Okay, so now in this session, let's talk about career choices or the career paths. So many times students will come to me and saying they don't have a career figured out. They like a particular subject. That's okay. And in fact, I think I even saw one more question earlier. That's okay. You know, I mean, my own Shreya did not have a like she changed her major like three or four times. And because she went to a school that was very lenient about it, liberal arts schools or liberal arts colleges are very open to letting students change. That said, university is also open, but not as open. Okay. So it's okay to not have made up your mind. In fact, it's a very good thing if you've not made up your mind. I meet ninth graders who are like, I want to become a doctor. I'm like, dude, you have no freaking clue what you're talking about. So it's good to not have made up your mind till 19, 20 also. It's okay. Let's keep experimenting. But you know, it's important to dream big, know what your position in life is going to be. So career is super important in understanding that you will change your career in your lifetime at least three times or four times. Like I moved to academia now after being an engineer for so long. I used to run my own company before, then I moved into as a software engineer. And within engineering, I moved from sales into as a technical engineer, and now I've become an entrepreneur running my own show. So even in my own career, I've incarnated three, four times. But you, it's fair to say that, you know, you're going to change, you know, given how quickly things are changing, it's fair that it'll take you like five, six times to change. So just don't get burnt out in school and, you know what you really want, okay? But careers, you know, the world is an oyster. There's so many careers you can look at, and don't get scared about the fact that there are so many careers to look at. Like when I was growing up in India, we had arts, commerce, and science. There were only three things you could do when you finished 12th grade, right? And or 10th grade. And then in Bombay, where I grew up. And then, but you know, here things are a lot more, so which is okay. So there are four kinds of degrees that you can get after you get through college. Okay, one is your associate level degree, which what you call as a double A degree. You can get an associate degree of arts, science, or applied sciences. Those are three different kind of which you go to a community college, like okay, what's called as a double A degree. Nothing wrong in going into a double A college degree, because especially like last time we had this conversation as well, that some colleges look at that very favorably to give you admission in the third year from a community college. So taking a double A degree is nothing wrong. In fact, if you don't believe you are ready to handle college level rigor, you want to work, stay close to home, it's a fantastic thing. In fact, in last 10 weeks presentation, I showed you some of the celebrities who went to community college and are still killing it. Okay. Bachelor's degree can be in arts and science, fine arts, or a applied science. Okay. So that's just four types of bachelor's degrees. What you don't see is things like a bachelor's degree in business or bachelor's degree in pre-med or in law, which is a reason. I mean, those are not things you plan for in the bachelor's level. You plan those at the master's level, but you could get into schools which are feeder schools to those particular kind of disciplines down the line. And then there are master's programs which are arts, science, MBA, or fine arts. And then you can also go into do PhDs, where you can get or what we call as the doctorate degrees, which typically are around philosophy, law. This is JD, there is MD, and then there is the dental surgery. Okay, now there are many more. This is just the common doctorate degrees. These are just the common master's degree, but that should give you a way very similar actually in some ways to what we saw in India. But just double A is what it is for vocational, which for we would just call professional courses. Nothing wrong in going to a vocational program as well. I think it's fantastic. You can see at Harvard what are some of the majors that people took. So this was about type of degrees. Now we're talking majors. We'll go into careers as well. Okay, but you can see economics was, you know, a fairly popular major, right? Over here, some statistics I picked on somewhere. You know, about careers, it's a very personal choice. And like when I was growing up, I was in 10th grade, I really wanted to be in merchant navy. I wanted to be sailing. I wanted to be on the ship. I wanted to make a lot of money. And so if somebody asked me what you want to do, I would say I want to go into merchant navy and become a sailor. And then my opinion became like, I want to become go to merchant navy and become a software engineer. I was like, there is no such job like this on a ship. But I just wanted to, I wasn't clear, but like if I had asked myself, what do I really enjoy? What I really enjoy is meeting people, communications, and, you know, closing deals and, you know, making people successful. What kind of a person am I? You know, I come from a fairly broken background. Like my father and I didn't talk for like 30 years and before he died, and then, you know, parents are separated. I'm a fairly broken person from my background, but I empathize with a lot of people of that kind of background, and I want to help them grow. So that's who I am. How do you like to learn? I'm a video learner. I hate reading books. So, you know, I'm more of a visual person. I like to shake, move hands, do things. So kind of go through that process for yourself, figure out who you really are, and you'll figure out a lot of things. But school really puts you at this level, right? You have these subjects in the school. It's okay to say, I like biology, but I also like music, and I'm not sure where I want to go. I like art because the teacher is cool. And in fact, in some ways, when I start putting a career template for a student, I actually look at these details and I start asking them in details, what about biology did you like? Or what about the music teacher besides the teacher? You know, did the tunes talk to you? You know, it's amazing how much you can get from a student by just going and asking why they like a particular subject as much. Most students, most older people, this is their regret, okay? So make sure that, you know, it's amazing how few people regretted not doing physical education, but math. I tell you, math is it, man. I mean, I was so low on my confidence. I mean, I almost failed in the 11th grade. But I had one thing going for me. I knew my math really well, okay? And then I killed it. I even today, when I kill it in the world, is because I'm super confident about my math. I'm arithmetically super strong, and it just goes with me forever. So if this is a strong weak area, double down, fix it now, okay? These are some of the careers where, you know, people tend to be a lot more satisfied. I actually know somebody who became a chemical engineer, and man, those guys, they make a lot of money because there are certain fields which don't change as much over time, and chemical engineering apparently is one of those things. So it's amazing. Psychology is the least of the people who are, and a lot of people want to go into psychology. This is hard stuff. So this is just talking about some careers, how people find. I'm in software, amazing career. I just love every bit of it. So I can dedicate a whole section to talking about how to plan for a CS career, but that's not a part of what I'm talking today. Okay. STEM really means science, technology, engineering, math. It does not mean medicine. STEM is only for geeks, nerds. That is different sciences, okay? So STEM, you know, but biology, here's some careers you can take from biology. You can become a biologist, forensic scientist, nurse, pharmacologist. You can actually go into agriculture as well. So biology is not about just pre-med. You can go into science research, sports medicine. You can become a nutritionist, athlete. It's funny, they talk about athlete himself also being in the biology field. But engineering, what that means, you know, paramedics, you know, career, this is what the careers are from biology. And again, all this I missed when I was trying to put together careers for Shreya. I didn't have very good answers to give to her. So I feel like this, you know, kind of data points over here of which schools, what kind of things you can do with biology as a career can be very helpful. This is a great career if you're looking at biotech as a career, like with CRISPR and some of the designer baby concepts that you're seeing in the world right now. This is killing it right now, right? Molecular diagnostics, small diagnostics. So having biotech, this field doesn't change as much. It's always going to be with COVID and stuff. This is always going to be required. And is within biotech, you don't have to be a scientist always. Like if you look at it, the scientist part of it would be very little. Actually, in fact, I don't even calling it out over here. Like regulatory, business, finance, project management. The people who just make a life, man, sitting over here doing this kind of stuff. So if you want to just smoke a cigar in your career, this is not a bad place to be doing it. Okay? Chemistry careers, again, forensic scientist, doctor, nurse, you know, very similar to bio careers. You can see some changes over here as well, right? In energy and utility, this is a chemical engineering side of what you were talking about, that it says 42% of the workforce engineer in the UK is over the age 45, which means, you know, a lot of engineers are going to retire, and so that need is required. It's just some statistical data around chemical engineering careers or just chemistry careers. The physics careers, you know, physics is like one of my Shreya's friends. She wants to become an astronaut, and she's hardcore into physics, so she really loves this stuff. What she learns here, chemical engineering, mechanical engineering. I used to be a I used to kill it in physics, which is kind of how I landed up in software as well. But you know, apparently, you know, construction has an area for architect, construction management, all that has physics requirements. This is some of the math careers you can look at, accountancy, banking. So math really opens up, in my humble opinion, for a lot of careers. If you're not good at math, you actually land up screwing yourself up a lot. So make sure you get your math stuff in place, man. This is about some of the engineer problems. Like, you know, what are the different types of engineers? I found this, you know, talking about what problems do they solve? And you can see that, you know, engineers don't have to be just software engineers. In fact, some of the software engineers, I being one of them, I actually don't even think we are engineers. We're just fake engineers. The real engineers are like mechanical engineers, civil engineers. I mean, the stuff they make, when it breaks, you know, people die. Okay, software is buggy like hell. And it's, again, I have a very jaded view of software because I'm an engineer myself, a software engineer. But this is just how engineering can take you in different areas, different apps you can do, types of engineers that are there in the world. So investigate. Don't just go into one form of engineering. Look at multiple forms. See where those take you and understand what they do, right? Mechanical engineers, marine engineers, biomechanical engineers. Look at your careers. I mean, be very deliberate about your career planning from these things. liberal arts is next. This is an area where, like, my Shreya is in a liberal arts school. People ask me, like, what kind of careers do you do after become a liberal arts major when you go out of liberal arts colleges? You can see there's a, you know, one thing is that if you look at all the good Ivy League schools, they're all actually liberal arts schools. They are good liberal arts schools, fantastic liberal arts schools with an awesome STEM program as well. Okay. So that's how they become a whole fully rounded program themselves. So understand that side of liberal arts, that what they expect you to have knowledge wise, what kind of careers you can make. So pretty much all these law and government attorneys, the senators, you know, Obama also had that same thing, right? Most of these guys have had a liberal arts background. Most CEOs in the world actually have a liberal arts background because they do their undergrad at liberal arts and then they go on to do like finance, business, become a holistic personality all across. This is some of the things you can do with a liberal arts background, become a teacher. You know, I think it's super creative. And money-wise, it's actually very similar, by the way. Okay, people who are in liberal arts careers, you might think they make less money, but that's not true. Okay, this is where history majors can take you into law, education. I really believe one should study this a lot. In consulting, it's a huge benefit, public sector as well. So, you know, when you learn about apportion stuff, don't think of it as just learning some past thing. It really opens your mind to looking at how the forefathers and how some revolutions happened, and it's a huge thing. High-paying jobs, as I talked about, with STEM majors. Petroleum engineering apparently gets a pretty high up in STEM majors, just some of the entry-level jobs out of school. This is about liberal arts careers. What kind of careers are open to you once you finish a liberal arts college? So you can see a lot of people do STEM stuff even after going out of liberal arts. Like Shreya is at a liberal arts school, but she's doing her internship right now at Microsoft. So she's going to be a software engineer coming out of a liberal arts school. This is how the pay stack up of liberal arts majors versus STEM majors. So you can see it's actually over 20 years kind of become similar. In the initial years, you might see that the liberal arts people are making less money than the other majors, but over time it actually balances out. So nothing wrong in this, doing a liberal arts background, okay? I think I'm going to stop at this point with my recording as well. And